My name is Vijay Shrivarshan Vijayaraja. I'm going to grade 10. I'm in Waterloo, Ontario, near Toronto, and I'm from Laurel Heights Secondary School. In grade 9, I took a business elective as one of my courses. And in that course, I have learned lots of new terms like sales, marketing, and that's where I came upon CRM. And I was very intrigued what CRM was. So I wanted to explore it even further. So then at the same time, my dad introduced Salesforce to me because he thought it was a good idea for me to learn it. And I was very interested in technology and I always wanted to learn new technology. And I had some coding experience prior, but Salesforce was a really different than any coding languages I learned. And yeah, that's when I started learning Salesforce. One of my main goals was to obviously pass the Salesforce admin exam. And whenever I finished a module in Trailhead or got a higher percentage in Focus on Forest test than before, my parents were always there and they motivated me. And they helped me, like, if I got a bad mark in, like, in the practice exam, they really motivated me and gave me the courage to keep going on. Of course, this is because before earning the certificate, I didn't really know which path I'm going to take post-secondary. I wasn't really sure if I was going to go into computers or anything else. But earning the certificate, now I'm really assured and confident that I'll go down the path of Salesforce and I'll continue going down this path. In my opinion, I would really say to focus on sales and services because in my case, I didn't really have any real-time experience prior to learning Salesforce. So these topics were really hard to grasp on. So I say you have to focus on these the most because the other topics, they didn't really need that much experience from before, but sales and service, they kind of do need the experience. Focus on Force really helped me a lot because they had a clear study guide. It was very simple to use. And their practice exams, which I took a lot, helped me identify where I'm weak at, where I'm strong at, where I really need to focus on more. And then if I even had any questions, I could just ask them on any topic. And then the Focus on Force community will get back to me before a day or two. Yes, because if you want to really explain your idea, if you have any new ideas and you want to expose it to the world, you have to have really good communication skills in order to get your idea out. So for me personally, when I first went into the exam center to take my test, I was really nervous because like everyone else was there a lot older. But then when I started going through the questions, they were a bit similar and had the same structure as the questions on Focus on Force. It made me realize that, wow, I could really do this. One of my first advices are to give yourself enough time to study and really know the concepts in Focus on Force study guides. And then with that knowledge, just play around with it in a new Trailhead playground. That's how I learned a lot of new things and how they work. And then you have to really take the practice exams because without the practice exams, you won't really know where you need to work on, where you're good at. At the end, I did pass. So Focus on Force really helped me. Thank you.